Hello student. So today we will study the next topic of plus one chemistry, Vascepa theory. This theory is suggested by Sidwick and Paul and developed by Gillespie and Nyholm. The full form of Vascepa is valence shell electron pair repulsion theory. Repulsion theory. In this theory, we have a polyatomic molecule in which one central atom is there and other atoms are connected to the central atom by covalent bond. Now, in this theory, the shape of the molecule is determined by repulsion between all of the electrons present in the valence shell. Electron pairs in the valence shell of the central atom repel each other and align themselves to minimize the repulsion. For example, in the case of BeH2, this is the central atom, it is connected to two hydrogen atoms by two covalent bonds. This one bond is formed by the sharing of electron between this hydrogen and beryllium. This other covalent bond is also formed by sharing of electron between beryllium and hydrogen. So this one bond is away from this second bond. This is called as a bond pair. One bond is made up of two electrons. So they both are away from each other by an angle of 180 degree. So that repulsion should be minimum. So in this theory, we will see the different molecule will show different kind of geometry and shape depending upon the number of these bond pair and number of lone pair, which are different in different cases. Lone pair are the electron which belongs to the particular atom, but they don't participate in bond formation. They will take up more space around the central atom as compared to bond pair. Lone pair attract more to the nucleus, but bond pair attracted by two atoms. Now you can see the lone pair repulsion is maximum, then lone pair repulsion is maximum, then non-pair-bond-pair repulsion, and bond-pair-bond-pair repulsion is minimum, you can say. That we will see with the help of various examples. So, how we can find out the geometry? So first of all, we have to find out the which is the central atom, then draw the electron dot structure and bar diagram, then find the arrangement of electron pair. Then find out arrangement of bonding pairs around the central atom. Then, on the basis of bonding pairs, we can find out the geometry, we can find out their shapes. Shapes of molecule containing bond pair of electrons only. So, we can have the bond pair as well as lone pair, or we can have only bond pair in a particular molecule. How? See, in the case of there are two electron pair in the valence shell of beryllium. 2s2, okay, 1s2, 2 electron, 2s2, 2 electron. So beryllium will just send the 1 electron from s2, p you can say, and it will make the two kind of, beryllium will make a two kind of a bond. This is one bond pair, this is another bond pair, which are away from each other by 180 degree angle, which already I told. So in this structure is called as a, this structure is called as linear arrangement, and this is called as a AB2 type. One table is given in your lesson in which we can find out the angle between the bond pair and the arrangement. In the next you can see the center atom with 3 electron pair. The 3 electron pair. So that is called trigonal planar. So 3 electron pair in the boron, we have 2s2, 2p, 1 electron from 2s2 go to 2p, and then it will make a 3 bond pair. 3 covalent bond will be formed, 1, 2 and 3. These 3 bond pair have an angle of 120 degree, you can see. This is also angle of 120 degree, this also angle of 120 degree. And this is called AB3 arrangement. And geometry is trigonal planar, you can see. Then we have 4 electron pair. For example, carbon, it has a 4 valence electron. So we have in 2s, we have 2 electron. So 1 electron from 2s move to 2p. So then we have 2s, 1, 2p, x, 1, 2p, y, 1, 2p, z, 1. So we have 4 atomic orbital. Later on we will discuss that these atomic orbitals combine to form 4 new orbital with the same shape and same energy. That concept is called hybridization, and every orbital will have a single electron, or you can say unpaired electron, which will show the overlapping. That overlapping and making the covalent bond in terms of energy, in terms of orbital, we will discuss in the next portion of the lesson. So here you can say carbon will make a 4 bond. So these are 3 dimensional bond. Carbon is combining with this hydrogen and this hydrogen. The angle between these is called as tetrahedral angle, which is 109.5 degree or 109.28 minutes, you can see. Then when we have a 5 electron pair, then there will be trigonal planar, you can say. So 3 chlorine are in the same plane. They all have 120 degree angle, which is shown here also. And one, this Cl is out of the plane, one is inside the plane. So this Cl is making 90 degree with all these bonds. Okay. So this symmetry is called as the, this is called as the trigonal. And one, this chlorine is there. So it will make a one pyramid out of the plane, one pyramid inside. So the two pyramid will be formed. That's why its symmetry is, its geometry is trigonal bipyramidal. Trigonal bipyramidal. Now 6 electron pair, octahedral. Okay. So by this way we can find out the geometry and arrangement. It can be AB2, AB3, AB4, AB5, AB6. When there is only bond pairs, no lone pair. When the lone pairs are there with the bond pairs, then the geometry will be different. So central atom with 4 electron pair tetrahedral. Okay. Now in the case of nitrogen, you can see the 1s2 that is present in the inner shell. 1s2 has 2 electron. So there is lot of difference of energy between 1s and 2s. So electron cannot move from 1s to 2p because there is a difference of, huge difference of energy from 1s to 2p. So this 2s and 2p, how many orbital are there? 4 orbital are there. 1 is 2s, 2 electrons are there, 3 are 2p, 2px, 2py, 2pz. These four orbital combine to form four new sp3 orbital. As I told that hybridization I'll discuss later on. So four orbital will form, and out of the four, only three will make the covalent bond. This fourth is lone pair. The electron pair which is not participating in the bond formation is called as the lone pair. So this lone pair doesn't participate in a bond formation. Only these three orbital which have a single electron, or you can say the half field, they will only participate in the bond pair. So we can find out that this lone pair will push this bond, and this lone pair will push this NH bond. So the bond angle between these two will reduce, you can see. So that's why instead of tetrahedral angle 109.5 degree, this angle will be 107. In the case of ammonia, this angle is 107. In case of water, or you H2O, you can say this bond angle will be more or less, because there are two lone pairs. So this lone pair will just push this bond pair, this lone pair will push this bond pair, and these two lone pair will push each other also. So these two bond pair, these two lone pair will push each other away from each other, and this lone pair will push the this bond pair also. So because of that presence of two lone pair, the bond angle will be very less, lesser than ammonia. Okay. So in the case of sulfur, because of the presence of lone pair, the more lone pair you can see, the symmetry will be different. So this was all about today's topic.